Yeah.
Now we're going to use all the I'll be here and I'll turn on a couple of lights back on. When you're gonna hold up that book,
yeah.
I'll turn a couple of lights back
okay,
on.
Yeah.
It's okay, yeah. Very careful, you don't trip on that corner.
That's okay.
I had visions of you being on the floor.
Now?
Thank you.
translation of it, if you're curious. This book of poetry contains materials that are dated, we're pretty certain that date back to 600 BC. And here, there's a passage that says, I have fine guests. We play the lute, we play the guitar, we play the lute, we play the guitar. And that in Chinese is, 我有嘉宾，五色古琴，五色古琴。 And the word qin is this instrument, qin. So here it is, the proof of the date of this instrument. Thank you very much, Charles, for showing me that. The first piece that Dr. Wang Bi has played for you is called Elegant Night, which is very fitting here. It's a 17th century piece. Although the instrument is quite old, the music for this instrument, the oldest piece dates the end of the 6th century. That piece, called the Elegant Orchid, is a very long piece. And it was not known until, we didn't know about it until the 20th century, when the manuscript, the 10th century manuscript of that piece was discovered in the Japanese temple. For a much older, a much later example of Qin music, I have here the so-called the oldest collection of Qin music. This is dated 1425. Of course, this is a photographic copy of it. So the earliest collection of this size dates back to the early 15th century. The notations tells you which finger press on which string at which position on this board, and which finger, right hand, would pluck it, would pull it inward or push it outward with your index finger or middle finger and your thumb and so forth. So it is a tablature. It shows you how to manipulate the thing, but it doesn't tell you the tuning of the string. So you have to know the tuning of the string to really decipher what the actual note is. And that is a problem for Chinese music historians for a long time. The standard form now has seven strings, and this is one of the typical tuning. This is one of the standard tunings. And there are studs here with inlaid mother of pearl showing where you should stop the string. It stops, the positions are one half, one third, one quarter, one fifth, one sixth, one eighth. So you can tell that by lightly touching the string at those instrument or the literati, so socially it does occupy a very high position. You very often will find in some scholars' studies, some qin would be hanging on the wall without strings, meaning that he respects the music, respects the instrument, but he doesn't play it himself. But that is enough to show that you are person with very evident taste. So socially, this does occupy a very special place in Chinese society. Is there anything else I want to say? Maybe after Dr. Wang plays the other pieces, you might have some questions afterwards. You might ask later on. So we will ask, let's see, we go on and play the other three pieces. The next piece that she will play is a song of the fisherman. This is an 18th century piece. It depicts the sunset, the scene of the sunset. An old fisherman sails his boat on his way back home. But his fish, boat is full of fish, and he's happily singing away and also drinking, and also slaps the side of his boat to keep time with his singing. So you hear some of the slapping sound normally qin as well. Thank you. this is the order of the pieces that the one's going to play. 15th century. Thank you.
so new to me, because this music is so new to me, I would like it if Wang Di played any one of these pieces again, whichever one she would look most like to play again. Don't ever play a new piece, play one of these again.
you said the last collection was published in the 1930s. Is there anyone who still actively composes?
Well, we don't know anybody who composed pieces for the team. Mm. In fact, all the pieces that are in existence, including all the pieces that have belonged to the family, are like anonymous composers, if you call them.
People are reconstructing. Often they reconstruct, reviving old pieces.
Yeah.
In it, I think there's some composition.
There's a composing process going on. Certainly, it differs from person to person. In fact, for each person, upon different playing, would have slight differences.
And was the scholars that you had played this thing?
It is the tradition that scholars play them, but I'm sure there are other Tula. There are various scholarly merchants and other kind of people who play. Yes, the story of the stones, this is the famous Chinese novel, Dream of the Red Chamber. It's a nun. She was playing the hero and his girlfriend were listening, eavesdropping outside. And because there's an eavesdrop, someone eavesdropping, suddenly a screen broke. That's a tradition too, that if somebody is eavesdropping, something will happen. still, and it is also used to accompany singing. In fact, Dr. Wang is now doing her research on the use of this as an accompaniment to singing.
Under what circumstances in, say, traditional Chinese society of, say, 1850 or 1650, would most people have heard the qin in a circumstance somewhat like we're experiencing right now? And under what circumstances in traditional Chinese society, say, in 1850 or in 1650, would the qin have been heard in circumstances something like what we have right this minute? I mean, this situation right here, a group of people sitting around listening in a sort of meditative situation, a small group of people in a household.
I would think it's even rarer now to have a gathering like this in place to listen to the qin. Of course, in a library is a very appropriate place. What do you think?
Well, the 19th century maybe under a cherry blossom, you know, the
Fasani,
yes. Often in the Oriental garden you have a part that's partly inside and partly outside that opens out to the garden, and yet you are under a roof. There it's by the favorite spot. Gathering. Or sometimes deep in the mountains, just by yourself. That is true, according to records, maybe in the bamboo grove.
Uh-huh.
Playing for yourself.
Uh-huh.
Or playing with nature.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, in the monastery, in front of monks will play.
Is it usually this in the Buddhist concept normal?
Yes, it's, I don't know if Professor Bien, in the oldest record, the qin player often give you a shamanistic atmosphere. They're supposed to have, the earliest record, they're supposed to have magic power. And not only the player, but the listener must be good enough. Otherwise, it's not healthy. For instance, if the emperor was virtuous, not up to it, after you listen to it, there might be a disaster. So, there's a religious aspect of it.
Rulon, to close the evening, why don't you ask Wang Yu to play the piece about the yeast once more, and then we'll